got him. Draw their fire.
Cover me now.
Oh boy.
I got him.
Closing on target. Assembling enemy forces.
I've got him.
Target locked.
Hypervelocity gun available.
I'm losing. He's headed your direction.
And it's a big battle. Alrighty, hello, hello. We're going to be playing some Star Wars Thrawns Revenge here. This is actually a mod for the Star Wars Empire at War game. I have a few games I started, just kind of trying out the different factions so far. Got a few hours in both, basically all of them. Just trying to, you know, get a little playtime in it, see what I think about this mod so far.
Reinforcement.
I like it a lot, actually, from what I've played. A lot of cool stuff. Turn on all my little indicators here, and we'll take a look here. I can show you guys what we all got going on. So, I'm playing as the Pentastar Alliance, I think it's called, or Pentastar. Anyways, something along those lines. So basically, they're a fringe group of the Empire. And one of the Moffs basically kind of took control of this outer section here, and basically, I'm fighting everybody right now. It's me and the Imperial Remnant, the Hand, and the New Republic, of course. They're basically the ones in control of the galaxy, so I'm trying to take it over. Now, these guys are a lot different than the other factions I've played as. They actually have access to a lot of older units. I don't know if any of you guys are fans of Star Wars at all, but they have some of these older units from Clone Wars, actually, which is really cool. They have these Hailfire droid tanks and the Lats, of course, and then the Podwalkers with that massive gun on top of them, basically walking artillery from my experience. But yeah, they have those, and then as far as ship units, you know, spaceships, they have a couple different classes of ships too, you know, the old Munificent and where is it? The Venerator, Star Destroyer. The only downside is the Venerator does not have the that massive beam that it has on a couple of the other mods that I've played. It usually gets that. It doesn't have that on this one, which kind of a downer. It's actually more of a carrier on this one than a straight line big old brawler. But yeah, these guys also have a really big ship here, the Praetor Battlecruiser, and the Imperial Star Destroyer 1 and 2, and Victory Star Destroyer 1 and 2s, and then course the good old acclimator. So I really like these guys. They're kind of a mix and match of some old and new stuff, and they also have access to some really good ships. Like these Praetors are tanks, absolute tanks. But yeah, let's get into this, see what we got going on here. Alright. Well, okay, so he's sending one Praetor battlecruiser. Oh, okay, well let's take a look here. Actually, I have this. This is kind of one of my frontline worlds right now, so I kind of have it stacked up more than anything. It's have a couple of ground-based weapons that will really help us out here. We'll show you that as soon as we start this match here. But yeah, so far this mod's worked really good. Not very buggy compared to some of the other ones I've played.
Enemy forces ahead.
Such as, you know, Republic at War and the Clone Wars. Those ones tend to have a little more bugs than this one, I've noticed at least. Let's see what this does to this guy. Yeah, these bigger ships have so much health that, I mean, even the hypervelocity gun's not going to do a whole lot to them. You know, they're taking 4 or 5 of those things in order to get destroyed. But, a couple things I have noticed, for whatever reason, it does seem like the AI doesn't mind suiciding its heroes, I guess I'd say. Now, a few times that I've played, usually either the New Republic or the Hand, the Empire of the Hand, it seems like they just kind of send in all of their heroes as one big... Oh boy, let's get this guy in here. They send in, like, their whole army of heroes just to take out, like, one of my planets. And then I'll kill a bunch of their heroes, and then all of a sudden we advance really far into the, you know, we'll advance, like, 2-3 eras in a matter of, you know, 15-20 minutes of gaming. Other times, though, when they don't do that, it can be a really long game. this, you know, this galactic conquest, depending on how many planets you're playing on, you know, you could easily sink, geez, you know, 12 to 25 hours into it. I mean, the fastest one I've done is like 13, 14 hours. And even then, I mean, I didn't fully complete everything, you know. It's a lot of gameplay, but a few times when they've suicided their guy's enemy, and then they're out of heroes by Era 5, it's kind of over with pretty quickly after that. I can kind of push through with my heroes, and a lot of my heroes have Super Star Destroyers like you saw right there, so, you know, when I have stuff like that, it's a little bit of an unfair advantage for me, but, you know, it's just the way the AI works sometimes. A couple notes about this mod, though. There is going to be...
Oh, sweet. Enemy fleet approaching.
Oh, boy. We're a tanker. Oh, isn't that just right over here? Again? Okay. Okay, anyways, like I was saying, a couple notes about this mod, though. There is going to be an update released for this. This is 2.1. They're going to be releasing version 2.2, and I've seen a little bit of the gameplay on that, and that's looking really good. They changed a lot of the, kind of some of the core game mechanics, which is really cool, actually. That'll be a cool new take on it. And then there's also some, I think they added a few more heroes, a couple of factions as well, and then probably a few different of the campaigns you can play. This is a total conversion mod for this, so it's really cool. There's actually a couple different, well, actually there's a lot of different different campaign missions or scenario type things that you can actually complete if you wanted to do. A couple of them are pretty fun. I played a few of them. They're really cool. One of them, you're actually teaming up with the New Republic as the Imperial Remnant. You're all kind of after the same enemy, so you guys actually form a temporary alliance, and that was really cool. You actually got to use units from both factions, which that was really cool. Kind of, it was really nice doing that, because then you can kind of see the pluses and minuses of both of them without having to, you know, set up two separate games. So that was nice. I definitely enjoyed that. Okay. See, this is kind of what I'm talking about. He's just kind of sending in one of his main guys here, so... Tektra class Star Destroyer. Okay, I think I remember what that is here. We're actually going to build... Oh, I don't have access to it. That kind of sucks. I was really hoping that I would have one of the immobilizers. Oh, I do right there. Immobilizer 418. I just want a couple of these. The few times that I've played, the AI isn't super dumb on this. I mean, this was a really tough... I'm not going to lie. I mean, I've already got a few hours into this, and the way it started was not in my favor at all. I mean, I was losing planets left and right, and it took me about a good 4-5 hours of gaming before I was able to kind of, you know, stop the onslaught, really, and slow them down. And it really helped killing their heroes, too. They kind of stopped pushing for a while after that. But one thing with the AI in combat I've noticed is when one of their heroes starts getting damaged, especially one of their heroes with like a Super Star Destroyer or an Executor class Destroyer, they'll retreat. And especially, it's really annoying with the Super Star Destroyers because, you know, they don't have any engines. I mean, you look at this, there's no engines for you to kill, and if you're not killing the engine hardpoints, they can just retreat away. So, I mean, he'll come in and kill a handful of my ships, and I'll have their Super Star Destroyer just about dead, and then... Oh, let's get this guy real quick. And then they'll just retreat away right before I can kill him. So, that's happened a few times on here, so that's really annoying, actually. But I do like it, though. It's definitely a different challenge, you know? I mean, they're smart. They're going to hit and run on you, and then, you know, doing that, that's... It's tough to combat, honestly. I mean, you can build as big of a fleet as you want, but they're still going to take out two or three of your ships. So that was kind of fun. As annoying as it is, I guess. Let's get some of these Praetors up here. God, these things are so badass. They have so much range, too. I'm pretty sure that they have the longest range out of any units on this game. Because, man, they have so much range.
There's our velocity gun available.
Big Imperial class 2 Star Destroyer there. There we go. Watch this. Oh, man. look at that fleet. Just fighters everywhere. See, yeah, that's another one of their heroes dead right there. So.
Brigade standing by.
Yeah, I don't know what they're gonna do about that, but.
Enemy fleet approaching.
Oh, they keep invading the same place. Usually, when he would do this, it was because they were getting ready to attack me somewhere else. So. But. It's between these two that keep attacking me here. I might go for Dathomir, push to Yavin 4, and then take Telos. Or I take Ord Montel, which would be really nice. That's a lot of ground. You know, that's another ground production facility, plus a lot of mines, so. I don't know. Alright, well, we're going to do this battle, and then I think I'm going to cut her there, give you guys enough gameplay, see if I can get maybe a ground force one or something in.
There they are! Blast them!
Oh boy!
Star Destroyer reporting in.
Yeah, see, he's already taking fire here. Ooh! Moved a little bit of a fleet in this time. Good. Need to move him out. Scramble the fighters. Alright, we need to bring in our Praetors.
Our primary engine system is down.
Ooh! Boy, they're hammering on him.
Our shields are down.
So the Praetor in. God, I just have ships everywhere, and then I got this guy. Really hope we don't lose that Star Destroyer. Okay, he's stopped firing on him. Oh, he's turning around, okay. Plex, I'm bringing in this Praetor. He's. Yeah, another thing, you gotta be careful how much you advance on here, because I mean. A lot of times, the ships that they bring out aren't even all the ships that they have. So, I mean, they'll bring in this big fleet, and it's not even everything that they have, you know, and then you're behind their lines back here, and then they're warping in ships behind you, and that things can go from bad to worse really quickly doing that. I guess we'll take out the other pre-order since this one's just bumped on. Jarek's taking this. We're actually gonna bring you over here. Man! When you have all these carriers. So there's a Venerator. Not the greatest looking model. It's a little patchy looking, but I mean. Doesn't look that bad though. And overall, they look good. Just when you get up close to the Venerators, they don't look that pretty. Okay. There he comes. Oh, and yes, and this can also happen. So these are, technically, they're kind of like space pirates of sorts. They're a faction completely on their own. They don't hold any planets or anything. And periodically, they'll just jump into your battle that you have going on. Doesn't matter if you're attacking or if you're defending. And they also don't always bring the same ships. This is... Wow, what is this? Four of these? Two of each? Right? Yeah, two of each. So two Imperial Star Destroyer 1s and Class 2s. Yeah, they'll bring different ships in. Sometimes they'll bring in some ships that the New Republic uses. Other times they'll bring in... Otherwise, sometimes they'll bring in like this. Four Imperial Star Destroyers, I mean, that's a big fleet that they'll bring in. That's probably the biggest that they bring in. Otherwise, usually they just bring in smaller, you know, Mon Calamari ships and things like that. But yeah, it's... You have to be really careful because, honestly, especially if you're attacking, they can really turn the tide of battle against you very easily. Especially like that, because they always jump in from the corners. So, I mean, you're moving in towards their... towards, you know, a space station or something like that, and they're jumping in behind you. And especially with these bigger ships, you know, it's not an easy task turning them around. So, you know, just gotta be careful of that. That has definitely got me a few times before, so.
Constructing unit. Vehicle in production.
Not a great way. But they can also be really helpful when you're defending, actually, because, you know, they're gonna be jumping in right behind the enemy, and they're gonna be taking out the enemy from behind while you're attacking them from the front. Kind of a 1-2 punch, actually, and it's It works out really well in your favor if that happens for you. That's actually it's actually saved me a few times on here. What was I gonna build again? I feel like it was gonna this thing. I'm building this so that way when he does attack me with that big freaking executor class with Wedge Antilles, building that so that way he can't run away from me. Because I've basically, this happened two or three times now where I should have destroyed him. But
enemy fleet approaching.
Okay, well, we're gonna get these.
Head to talk.
Those guys. Ah, see, there he is right there. Yeah. So yeah, this, I guess this will just have to be a good showcase for you guys. Very annoying. Let's see what you brought in, actually. A couple of assault frigates. Wow, you don't really bring in much of a carrier fleet. Usually when he brings Wedge in, he brings a lot of carrier ships. Kind of like the old Venerators. It carries a lot of starfighters and a lot of bombers. Usually he'll bring in ships just like that, so that way they can overpower me of fighters, but last two times beginning he actually hasn't done it, so I don't know why. But okay, well here we go. It's be a big battle. Okay.
The enemy is approaching.
Okay, we're gonna need to move this guy right meow. Otherwise he's gonna come under. We're gonna hit him right off the bat.
One day, everything.
Where is this? Okay. Yeah, Priador is already firing on him, so we're gonna move you in a position. Run, ship, run. Oh, there you go. Bring you up. Actually, not quite there. We're gonna bring you right there. And oh. This is so many Praetors. Oh boy, that's not good. We need him to get out of there.
Our engines are gone, sir.
They won't be there much longer. I have one day. Everything.
Our launch bay is gone.
Oh boy, they're hammering on him. That's not good. Okay. You guys I'm kind of lazy right now, and I'm just kind of sending everybody to hunt Seek. But that's mostly because have the time to, especially in a big battle like this where they got this big ship, I don't really have time to be messing around selecting everybody and having them team up on everything individually, although that does help you a lot. It looks like he's gonna get away. Well, hopefully. Oh, he's firing. Okay. As long as he's not returning, as long as he's not getting fired upon.
Not sure.
We got him in good position here, though. He's so big, you almost can't even see his health bar. There it is. Oh, yeah. Oh, well, we need you. He's probably gonna start unloading on my Praetors here pretty soon, but. Okay. Alright. More pirates came in. Holy crap! Well, that'll kind of help, I guess. Is the shields down yet? Oh, shields are down. How are your shields? Oh, you're good. Yeah, see, like I said, they'll come in different ships just about every time. So now they got some Victory Star Destroyers and an Imperial Star Destroyer second generation. Okay.
One day.
You can just stay parked there, honestly. Oh, see, yeah, see, this is exactly what he's gonna do. So, since this guy is dying, he's like, well, I'm not gonna lose that unit. I'm gonna hyperspace out of there, even though he's just about done. but no engines, because he can't kill him, so... Yeah, if I had the immobilizer, I could actually prevent him from retreating, which would be really nice. That's a big hero. That's a big hero for them to be losing. So yeah, we just got the little itty bitty guys, none of the big ones. Perfect. And they're attacking me yet again. Perfect. Okay, so we're gonna try to be taking Ord Montel here. See how this goes. I think that they just didn't really pay too much attention, honestly. But I'm pretty sure that they don't have anything here besides just a fleet of starfighters. Maybe a space station. All easy pickings. The Hand, for the most part, I've played as them for a little bit. The only thing I did not like about them is that after I think the second or third era, they don't get any better ships. Like, that's kind of it for them. Which, it's not really a huge deal. Like, for instance, these guys, I don't think after Era 3 we get anything different. But we have access to Praetors, which... These things kick ass, basically, the entire game, so... Granted, the, what city are you guys in? Oh, yeah, see, these things you gotta be careful of, because these things will do a lot. These right here, these triple heavy Mega Masers. Oh, that's a cool shot. But yeah, they have really good capital ships. It's kind of like their counter... Their counterpunch to the Imperial Star Destroyer. They're big phalanx destroyers, but they're really good. Especially, they're really good at taking down shields. Their weapons are really strong for that. But other than that, though, like, they don't... You know, it takes a good three or four of them to take on one of these Praetors, which, when you're playing as them, gets really annoying, because obviously you're not... It's not going to really help you out too much.
Ready for duty.
I should have stacked this a little better, I guess, but oh well. So the nice thing about this Praetor is, I'll show you guys exactly how much range these things have. Shooting at... Oh, just some bombers. Okay, I'll show you guys the range these things have. I'm basically going to be able to just park these things right out of the range of this thing right here and just kind of hammer away at it. It's pretty impressive. Look at this, they're already hitting this thing. So you can actually stop right there. Oh boy, that's not good. We're actually gonna send you back. There's pirates right there. Oh boy, that's not good. Should have turned him around and have him come back. For some backup, basically. Stop him. Oh boy. Oh, he took a beating there. Yeah, these Venerators, they don't have much of a punch anymore, so they just have... The biggest thing they have is two dual turbo lasers up front, where, I mean, you look at these Praetors, well, they're not really a fair example because they're a lot bigger, but... And everything's heavy. Heavy ion caser. Heavy ion turbo lasers, heavy ion cannons. The other thing too, the Imperial Star Destroyer twos. I mean, they have, yeah, right here, quad turbo lasers. I mean, it's just ridiculous. I mean, they're stacked, very stacked. This thing's taking a beam here. Wow, that is a lot to read. Probably not going to do that.
Tightening up. I'm on this coming around. Engines are coming in chart. Under control. Let's count up on the next position. Nowhere to go. Excellent shot.
Well, the good news is I don't think he lost his hangar. Yep, hangar bay is still in there. All right. So he's going to be able to keep making ships, which is good. Okay. Move you guys in. Actually, we're going to move you right there. Move you. there. Right out of their effective range, basically. Reporting.
Awaiting instructions. Yes, Commander. Black
team. These guys haven't even lost any shields, so that's just ridiculous. I guess they're just like, screw the fucking space station. I was like, whatever, forget that thing. Mega Mazer. Yeah, that's the name of the weapon that the hand hat uses, is the Mega Mazer, which, especially like that big platform that I took down earlier, that platform with those big quad Mega Mazers on the corners there, or dual Mega Mazers, whatever they are, those things will eat your shields. I've played as the hand a few times, and every time I play as them, the whole strategy, especially defensively, is, you know, draw them in close enough to those platforms, and let those big cannons do work, because that's what they do. They just, especially two of them, you have two of them at the same time. I mean, those Praetors are no match, honestly. I've done it a few times where you just bring the Praetors in, and as soon as they're within range of that thing, you know, four shots from them, and the Praetors' shields are down, and then you just kind of focus fire on them. And as long as you can keep the shields up on your ships, you can win just about anything. But yeah, you're definitely going to want to make sure, especially on your frontline planets on this game, that you're going to want to definitely make sure you install a hypervelocity gun. Well, it's like a plasma weapon or something like that, it says in the game, but when you build it, it says hypervelocity. Yeah, something the devs missed, but anyways, definitely going to want one of those. They help a lot, especially for
enemy unit sighted.
This faction that I'm playing as, it seems like it recharges really fast. Like, super fast. Crazy fast. I mean, the other ones, it's almost double the amount of time. Wow. That just one-shot a Mon Cal ship. That's pretty impressive, actually.
I'm sure.
Scramble the fighters. So three Praetors, two carriers, and Imperial Star Destroyer.
Bombers at the ready.
Yeah, I mean, look, I just fired that, 15 seconds ago, maybe? And it's already completely done? Or just about completely done? That's crazy. The other faction I played as, theirs took a lot longer. That was one of the first things I actually noticed playing with this faction, is how much faster their weapon is, because, like I said, I was getting attacked right off the bat. I'm sure it's going to take one of these. I'm going to stop moving there a little bit. Oh wow, it didn't. That's weird. Maybe just didn't get a good angle. I've noticed that sometimes if the ships are moving around too much, it'll either miss or sometimes it just won't have a good solid hit on them. These Praetors actually move decently fast too. I think it's because of the triple engines they got. Move pretty good, especially for a bigger ship. That's gonna do it for these guys. Boom. Get some ground combat in for you guys before I cut this off here. I'm actually going to try to do a let's play on this, or a bit of a walkthrough, really, see what we can do. This is just kind of just a showcase of this mod in general.
Invasion commencing.
That's not going to show me anything on the planet. Okay, I'm pretty confident. These Hailfire droids are badass. Not even joking. Actually, you start out with just a couple of them, and that was one of the first things, one of the first planets I actually ended up losing, but, man, I killed a lot of units with just a single squad of these things.
Choose your reinforcements.
Kind of feel like spamming a bunch of them now. Look at these guys here.
Order acknowledged.
And, these things are pretty good too. The lats are pretty good. These things definitely take the cake, though. They have a little, like, a minigun on the bottom, and they have, you know, the rocket pods. So, they're pretty effective against everything, honestly, I've found.
Ready, sir.
These guys are really good, too. These pod walkers,
firing. Open fire.
They have, you can really see it, but they have that massive cannon on the top of them. It takes a while for it to fire, but does a lot of damage.
Reporting.
We'll try to get you guys, maybe here.
Affirmative.
Position.
I was kind of ordering them to attack move so I can pay a little more attention to the map
Lance
itself.
Standing by.
Oh, flankers are there. We might lose these guys, but I'll have to actually assist.
Aerial artillery reporting.
Yeah, these guys think they're Lancet wings.
Ready for orders. At the ready.
There we go. Usually they have some kind of base on here, but okay. We'll go over there then.
Comlink active. Target in range.
It's kind of cool. I've just seen a train of them.
Look, sir. It's them.
Oh, that is a turbo laser battery. We're going to want to move. Oh, boy. We're going to want to get you guys out of there. That right there. That is
unit destroyed.
The one thing I really liked about this. Holy crap. We got a lot of them. Okay, one thing I really liked while playing with that faction was the fact that... Actually, you guys should probably just stop right there, because... there we go. The Mega Mazer tank is ridiculous. Sure, it takes a while for it to fire, but man, that cannon is devastating, to say the least. It's ridiculous. It is very overpowered, but that's okay with me. It was a lot of fun playing as them.
Moving out.
Orders received.
Okay, so I'm gonna take that, and I'm gonna wait actually for this bombing. This bombing run, I think. Might be a better idea to do that instead of losing a bunch of units. This is a capturable building on the map. It's an abandoned sensor array, so once I capture this, it's actually gonna reveal the whole map. Which will be awesome for me because I have ships in orbit, so I'll be able to call in a bombing run and an orbital strike, but, you know, I can't do it on things I can't see, so. We're gonna call it in, probably right in here. Unless I can find their shield generator. If I can do that, then that completely eliminates the need for them. Okay, well, let's get you guys loaded in here.
Affirmative. Channel open.
Oh, I like how they even get the blue color. That's pretty badass. Ah, there we go. So, oh man, yeah, the shield generator's all the way over here. So, I can actually just do that. And, oh yeah. And they're also another thing, that Empire of the Hand, all their buildings are shielded. So, they might not be the greatest in space, but it seems like they definitely have a pretty good ground bonus, honestly. Their units are no slouch. This thing's pretty cool too. It's kind of like a mobile artillery, really.
Yes, sir.
We'll keep you guys there. Move these guys here.
Comlink active. Receiving orders.
Roger. Advancing.
Well, I'm gonna bring you guys back since there's obviously nothing down there. Some pads, looks like. I'm gonna wait for this bombing run to come in, and then I'm gonna lay out this thing, take out the turbo lasers, because otherwise they're just gonna sit here and defend. I've played against these guys a few times, and they definitely like to hang out by their main bases, which good idea on their part. I mean, they've Sure, I've beaten them a few battles, but man, they've really made me pay heavily for planets I'm taking. Would like this not to be one of those. We can drop this.
Roger that.
These guys too.
As you wish.
Reporting in.
Bombing run available.
Perfect.
Squadron moving out.
Ready to receive orders.
Boom. And here they come. So we can get a good shot on there. We go.
Attack run.
This map's kind of screwy because it's so big, but. Oh, we might get the tank too. Looks like we got him. Yep, okay, so all their guns are offline now. There's a shield generator. Okay, so yeah, all their guns, see how they're all pointed downwards. Man, they have four of these things. Good God. Five. Okay. And a bunch of speeder bikes. That's quite the combo. Okay. We're gonna call in some aerial artillery, actually. I think I'm actually gonna leave the infantry out of this one.
Awaiting orders. Copy. I copy. Reporting.
Huh, that's all I have, really? Where's the... Where's the other one at? Oh, there's five. Where's this guy at?
Yes, sir.
At? Oh, you're all the way over here. Okay, come on.
Transit proceeding. Yes, Commander. Ready.
Group one. You guys can all be group two. Okay, so two. Let me get you guys in the open here.
Lancet standing by.
It's kind of funny they think that they're freaking lancets.
Firing. Engaging.
Get our aerial firepower up here.
I have the target in sight.
Take him out. Two.
Unit destroyed.
Oh man, he can shoot my planes on too. That's not good. Okay.
Ready for order.
One. Oh boy, what is going on here? Oh, that's not good.
Attacking target.
Right away.
Ready to receive order.
Missiles.
Comlink active. active.
It's like attacking, huh? Okay. Whatever.
Roger that. Fire at will. Form up. Cut through them. Waiting word. Command received.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you shouldn't be able to hit any of our stuff up here.
Copy. Targeting.
Kinda look cool, I guess.
Target reporting.
That should be it. Sometimes it does this. They possibly could get out of here, but sure. Okay, so we lost one lat, but they lost a lot of stuff, a lot of Mega Mazers. Well, they don't technically count because they're freebies, but still.
System control achieved.
Good battle. Put a space station up there right away. They actually can't. So, alrighty. Well, we'll call her there, I guess. That's a pretty good rundown of the mod, I believe. So, alrighty. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. I'm going to be doing some more mods, and obviously when the update comes for this mod, I'll be doing that as well. So, alrighty, hit that like button, smash that subscribe button. Thank you.